Hello everyone, I'm here to give an introduction of our poster paper, Understanding and Handling Alert Storm for Online Service Systems. Nowadays, service quality and user experience are vital for online service systems. To ensure the service quality, engineers collect various monitoring data, including metrics, logs, and traces. Once this data violates the predefined alerting rules, for example, CPU utilization exceeds the threshold, alerts would be generated to notify on-call engineers, and then engineers would start diagnosis according to the alerts. This is the general pipeline of alert management system in the real world. In practice, failures are inevitable due to the large scale and complexity of online service. However, the occurrence of a failure tends to be along with numerous alerts. This is because a service system contains many components, each of which has a huge amount of monitoring data, and the different components tend to be affected by each other. We call this phenomenon alert storm. Faced with so many alerts, it's time-consuming for engineers to manually examine each alert to diagnose the failure. Therefore, to facilitate the assurance of service quality, understanding and handling alert storm are very essential. To help understand alert storm, we conducted the first impairment core study to investigate it based on a large amount of real-world alert data. Through this study, we obtained three key findings. First, alert storm occurs frequently, about once a week, and brings great trouble to engineers in practice. Second, the current practice of identifying alert storm is just to set a fixed threshold, which cannot fit the dynamic online environment. Third, some alerts in alert storm are irrelevant to the failure, and also many alerts have a certain correlation, for example, textual and topological correlation. In summary, this study further motivates the necessity of handling alert storm and provides us some guidelines. Inspired by the findings from our study, we proposed the first approach to handling alert storm, which contains two components, alert storm detection and alert storm summary. Specifically, for online alert data, we formulate the alert storm detection problem as online change point detection and adopt extremely value theory to detect alert storm adaptively and accurately. Then, if an alert storm case is discovered, the second component will be triggered to assist engineers to identify the problem. Alert storm summary includes three steps. Learning-based alert denoising, which aims to filter out irrelevant alerts to the failure. Clustering-based alert discrimination, which aims to divide the alerts into different groups. And the representative alert selection, which aims to extract the most typical alert from each cluster to recommend to engineers. Through the above three steps, we can obtain a small set of typical alerts that are relevant to the failure and reflect the failure from diverse aspects, so that engineers can spend less time handling the alert storm instead of analyzing all alerts. To evaluate the effectiveness of our approach, we conducted an experimental study based on 166 alert storm cases from a large commercial bank and obtained these conclusions. First, our approach can detect alert storm more accurately compared with the traditional threshold-based method, achieving an F1 score larger than 0.9. Second, our approach can reduce the number of alerts that engineers need to examine by larger than 98% and accurately recommend representative alerts related to the failure. Third, each component of our approach is effective and outperforms other baseline methods. And finally, our approach can achieve a relative short response time, which is user-friendly for engineers. That's all. Thank you for your attention.